Selenium class 10, Java control flow statements. Yesterday we started this topic, continuation. We have three types of flow control in Java. Not only in Java, in computer programming, we have three types of control flow statements. One is conditional statements or decision making statements. Second one, looping statements, loop statements. Third one, branching statements. See, yesterday we started conditional statements or decision making statements. In this conditional statements, we discussed nearly five types of usage. First one, execute a block of statements when a condition is true. Second one, execute a block of statements when a condition is true. Otherwise, execute another block of statements. Third one, execute a block of statements when a compound condition is true. Fourth one, execute a block of statements when a compound condition is true. Otherwise, execute another block of statements. Next, fifth one, decide among several alternates using another name of the structure, else if. Next, sixth one, execute a block. Again, we will use these control flow statements in our Selenium test cases. Now, just we are discussing basic things, syntaxes as well as examples. Okay. Sixth one, execute a block of statements when more than one condition is true. Another name of the structure, nested if. Syntax, if condition, close parenthesis, open curly braces. Next, again, if condition, open curly braces. Next, if condition, like this, you can write number of conditions based on your requirement. Suppose I opened three conditions. See, condition one, condition two, condition three, like this. Next, statements. Next, close curly braces. We opened three if structures, close three curly braces. Observe example. Observe Uma Devi. Yesterday we discussed na compound condition example.
Yes, sir.
Same example, but difference is there. See, declare or initialize four integer type variables. Suppose A equals to 100, B equals to 90, C equals to 80, D equals to 70.
These are local variables, right, sir?
Not local variables, instance variables. Local variables means we declare local variables in code blocks. Code blocks, not only methods, code blocks. If it is conditional block or loop block or method block, any problem?
No, sir.
Here we are writing we declared these variables in main program. These are instance variables. non-static variables,
Okay, sir.
but not local variables.
Okay, sir.
Next, if A greater than B, open curly braces. Next, if A greater than C, next, if A greater than D, A greater than D, observe, if A greater than B, A greater than C, A greater than D, then declare A is a big number.
Yes.
Just a minute. A is a big number. A is a big number. Now observe, it is one way condition, nested if, but one way. Observe the data, A greater than B, condition 1 true, A greater than C, condition true, condition 2 also true, condition 3, A greater than D, condition 3 also true, then it will declare A is a big number.
A is a
run. A is a big number. Suppose condition 1 true, condition 2 true, condition 3 false, and no else part in the structure, so nothing. It will bypass the condition. Bypass the condition. Suppose condition 1 true, second condition false. If second condition falls, it won't check third condition. No else part. So nothing. Next. Condition 1 false. Condition 2 true. 3 also true. But if condition 1 fails, then it will. Then it won't check remaining. It will check one by one. Just a minute. Now condition 1 is true, condition 2 also true, 3 also true, and then it will execute. A is a big number. A is a big number. Just a minute. A is a big number. Next observe syntax 2. It is not second syntax, another usage. Observe, suppose you can write else parts optional, if required you can write. Suppose after third one, else, open curly braces, close curly braces. Close curly braces. Next, after this one, next, end one. See, first if close, else close, second if close, else close, next, third close, else last one. Observe. Suppose same. I'm giving one example. Find the difference between compound condition and nested condition. Nested condition is powerful. You can locate the problem easily. Observe. Suppose my problem is problem find biggest number among four numbers. First, using compound condition. Next, same problem using nested condition. See, nested condition is powerful. Using compound condition, Umadevi.
Yes, sir.
First, I'm initializing four numbers. Find biggest number. Not only A. First, focus on A. If compound condition. If A greater than B. If A greater than B and A greater than C and A greater than D. Observe, if A greater than B, A greater than C, A greater than D, then we can declare A is a big number, na?
Big number, yes, sir.
A is a big number. Next, observe. Next, focus on B. B greater than A, B greater than C, B greater than D, then we can declare B is a big number. B is a big number. B is a big number. Just a minute. First, focus on only. Okay. Focus on only one. First, focus on only one. I'm changing my requirement. Find biggest number among four numbers. Find whether A is a big number among four numbers or not. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now it is enough. Else, open curly braces. System.out.println. Now we are focusing only A. We are taking A is a big number or not. We are not focusing B, C, D. A is not a big number. A is not a big number. Now observe, according to the input, A is a big number. Means first condition true, second one true, third one true, operation is AND. If all are true, then it will display A is a big number. A is a big number. Next, suppose first one, A greater than B true, A greater than C true, but third one, A greater than B not true. Here operation is AND, so it will show A is not a big number. A is not a big number. Next, C big. Second condition false. A is not a big number. Next, first condition false. A is not a big number. Suppose all conditions are true. A is a big number. Working na?
Yes, sir.
Next. Okay, put mute Uma Devi. Next, you come Sevangi.
Yes, sir.
Same problem. Find whether A is a big number among four numbers or not. Using nested if. Nested if. Nested if. We already did na. Suppose A greater than B. Next, if A greater than C. Next, just a minute. Next, if A greater than D. System.out.println. A is a big number. Big number. Else System.out.println. A is not a big number. Run. A is a big number. Suppose third condition is false. A is not a big number. Suppose second condition is false. We didn't write else part, so it will bypass the condition. Next, first condition false. It will bypass the condition. Observe Sivangi, difference between these two. In this compound condition, we can write only one else part. Only one else part. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Suppose if third condition is false, it will show A is not a big number. It won't look at the problem. Second condition is false. Second condition is false. It will show A is not a big number. If first condition is false, it will display A is not a big number. Suppose if all conditions are true, then it will display A is a big number. It won't locate the problem. If it is nested if, you can write multiple else parts. Then you can locate the problem exactly. Observe. Suppose A is not a big number. This is third if. This else is third if. This else is, else belongs to third if. Third if. Third if. Just a minute. A is not a big number. Reason? Third condition is false. Third condition is false. Just a minute. This is closing. Here. Third condition. Why it is showing this one? First condition, second condition, third condition, close. Next, we opened else part, close else part. Oh, main method is there na? Class close. Okay. Now observe, all conditions are true. All conditions are true. Then it will display A is a big number. A is a big number. Suppose third condition is false, then it will show A is not a big number, third condition is false. We wrote else part for third condition. Third condition is false. Suppose second condition is false, no else part, so it will bypass the condition. Bypass. Provide the next after third condition. See, observe. First if last close, second if last but one close, third if immediate close, in these three if structure. Okay na?
Yes sir.
Suppose second condition, this is first condition. Now observe, you can look at the problem exactly. Now all conditions are true. Desired output is A is a big number. Next, third condition is false, then it has to display A is not a big number, third condition is false.
Yes, sir.
Third condition is false. Next, this time second condition false. It has to display A is not a big number, reason second condition is false. Second condition is false. Next, first condition is false. It has to display A is not a big number, first condition is false. Observe, locating na?
Yes, sir.
Now, tell me Shivangi. Nested if versus a compound condition versus nested condition.
Nested is much better.
Just a minute. Nested condition. You can say nested condition or nested if versus compound condition. Compound condition. See, in nested condition, we can write multiple else parts.
Yes, sir.
See, in nested if, we can write multiple else parts, multiple else parts. Whereas in compound condition, single else part only. Single else part only. So we can't look at the problem exactly. Which one, which condition fails? Third one or second one or first one? Common result. A is not a big number. But using nested condition, you can look at the reason. You can look at the problem. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now you come, Baba Wale. Last example for this conditional. Baba Wale, can you guide me?
Can you repeat that again?
Next.
Hello?
Tell me. I didn't explain the problem. Now I am going to explain the problem. You provide the solution. I will give a hint also. Observe the problem. Now, all of you familiar with conditional structures of Java. One more structure is there, that is switch case, that I will explain. Observe the problem earlier. Find the biggest number among four numbers. This is my problem. I have four numbers. I want to find biggest number. Observe hint. Use compound condition and else if structure. Else if structure. Solution. Find biggest number. I want to focus on all numbers. First focus on A. If A greater than B and next A greater than C and A greater than D. Open curly braces, then declare A is a big number. System.out.println. A is a big number. Okay na? Baba Wale not responding.
Yeah, go ahead, I'm here.
Okay. Next, focus on B. B greater than A. B greater than C. B greater than D. Then declare B is a big number. Here. After first one. Else if na. Next. Focus on C. C greater than A. C greater than B. C greater than D. Then declare C is a big number. Next, focus on D. You can write another else if structure, Uma Devi. Otherwise, you can use else. Else means other than above. Else means other than above. Now D only pending. You can write else if structure for D. Otherwise, else means other than above, means if A is not a big number, B is not a big number, C is not a big number, then D only big number, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Else system.out.println. D is a
big number.
Now observe Baba Wale. First I am focusing on A. Observe A value 1000, B value 900, C 80, D 70. A is a big number. It has to display A is a big number. Run. A is a big number. Next observe A 100, B 900, C 80, D 70. As per these input, B is a big number. Run. B is a big number. Next, C 800. In this case, C is a big number. C is a big number. Next, D 700. In this case, D is a big number. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Baba wale, are you okay?
I am okay.
Okay. What about you, Shivangi? Are you okay?
Yes, sir.
See, this is about sixth nested if and compound conditions variation. Next, one more structure is there. All of you put mute. You come, Sri Lalita. One more structure is there. Seventh one. Indirectly, we discussed this one. Observe. In Java program structure chapter, I used this structure. Again, I will explain with syntax. Decide among several alternates. Earlier, decide among several alternates using else if. This time, switch statement. See, switch structure was inaugurated in order to reduce the complexity of else if structure. See, using switch statement. Using switch statement. Observe the syntax, Lilitha. Syntax. Switch na. Switch. Expression. An expression in a programming language is a combination of one or more constants or variables or operators and functions that the program language interprets. Here I am going to use variable as expression. Based on that expression, it has to pick the case. An expression in a programming language is a combination of one or more constants, variables, operators, and functions that the programming language interprets. I'll show you an example, then you can get more clarity. Next. Case one, value, colon, next, statements, next, if this case is okay, then break the structure. Next, case two, like this you can write n number of cases, n number of else parts, n number of cases. Case three, next, case four, next, other than above, that is default. For default also you can write statements, Sri Lalita. Default means else like. We used else na, other than above. Default means else like. Close curly braces. This is the syntax. Observe the example, then you can get. I'm finding the grade. In Java program structure chapter, indirectly we discussed it. Example. So I'm taking one character variable, char grade. Grade is variable name equals to single quote. Suppose A. Semicolon. Next, I'm going to use grade as expression. Based on this grade, it has to pick the case. Based on this grade value, it has to pick the case. Suppose case Actually, in syntax, I used case 1. Actually, not case 1. Case, next, case name. Case name. Okay. See, case, single quote, A. Colon, next, SYSO, control space, enter. Excellent. Case. Next, break.
Break.
Semicolon. Why it is showing this one? One more. Still. Grade. Case.
Sorry, which is that?
No, we switch. we need to start with switch now.
Yes, sir.
Switch expression is grade.
Grade.
Expression is grade. Open curly braces. Now it is okay. Break. Next. Case value B. Suppose good. Next, case value C. Suppose okay. Next, default. Default is optional. Suppose invalid grade. Now observe, grade value is A. It will display, it will pick the first case. Excellent. Run. Excellent. Suppose grade value is Z. What is the output?
Invalid grade.
Okay, Baba Wale. Other than above, invalid grade. Suppose C.
Okay.
Next. Oh, again. Suppose B. Good. See switch structure. Okay, now Taimish, are you following or any confusion? Ask me.
No, sir, I'm good. Sir.
Okay.
I'm following. Thank you.
Okay. Next, observe Sri Lilita, one small note. This is about Java conditional structures, basic structures. Again, we will use these conditional structures in Selenium test cases. Okay. Now I just introduced basics. Observe one note. You can use conditions only in your program.
Okay, sir.
You can use condition, one or more condition only in your program. Second one, you can use loops only in your program. You can use loop only in your program. Next, third point, you can insert loops in conditions and vice versa. You can insert loops in conditions and vice versa. Means based on your requirement. Okay, now the start point, Shivangi. Any problem, Taimesh?
No, sir.
You come, Taimesh. Okay, Sri Lalita, I will call you later. All of you put mute except Taimesh. See, this is about Java conditional structures. Next, come to second one. In Java, second one, Java control flow. Java control flow. Loop statements. Java control flow, loop statements. This is first one. Java control flow. Conditional statements. We have four loop structures, Taimesh. Four loop structures. Or test automation point of view, first three loop structures are important. Fourth one, limited use or no use, but I will introduce all four loop structures. Can you list out the loop structures in Java?
Yes, sir. For loop?
For loop. See, this loop is English term. For is Java keyword. Suppose if it is VBScript, in loop structures, for next. For is starting keyword. Next is end keyword. While wend loop. While is starting keyword. Wend is end keyword. But in Java, only single keyword for loop structures are conditions. If open curly braces at end, close curly braces. For at end, close curly braces. While at end, close curly braces. Okay. For loop. For only Java keyword. Loop is English term. Okay. Second one.
Okay. Then while loop.
While loop. Next. Third
do
one.
While loop.
Do while.
And enhance for loop.
Enhanced for loop. Enhanced for loop. See, first three loops purpose almost all same. Based on your convenience, you can use them. Last loop purpose different. For first three loops, we use scalar variables. But for last loop, we use array. First, I am taking for loop time is for loop. In order to understand the loop structures, this is the pattern. Description. Next. Syntax. Loops for repetitive execution. In our test cases, we use loop structures for repetitive execution, data-driven testing. Next, conditional statements. Conditional statements to insert verification points and for error handling in our Selenium test cases. Syntax. Example. Observe the description, Taimesh. What is the functionality of for loop? It repeats a block of statements for a specified number of times. I already told. First three loops purpose almost all same. Last loop is some different. Not some. Last loop is entire different. For first three loops we use scalar variables. For last loop we use array. For loop. It repeats a block of statements for a specified number of times. Can you guess syntax? Ramesh, otherwise I will explain. Guess syntax, for loop syntax. Okay. Shivangi, can you guess
for loop four. Syntax?
Continue Baba Wali.
Four. Open parenthesis. It will be the starting value.
Start value.
Then semicolon.
Semicolon.
End value.
Semicolon. Next, increment.
Increment for slash decrement.
Increment or?
Or decrement.
Decrement. Okay, Baba Wale, you continue. Taimish. Next. Statements, close curly braces. Example one.
Yes.
Simple example. Print 1 to 10 numbers. 1 to 10 numbers. Enough. Print 1 to 10 numbers using for loop. Tell me the program.
Yes, sir. For?
For.
Open parenthesis.
Open parenthesis. Start value. You need to
declare.
You need to declare variable.
Yes.
Int. That is number.
Int. I equals to one.
See, you can use int a equals to one or b equals to one, but coding standard is use I, J, K like variables in conditional and loop structures. Next.
I less than equals to 10.
Less than or equals to 10. Again, semicolon.
Then I plus plus.
Unary operator.
Yes.
Next. System.out.println. I. It will display 1 to 10 numbers. Run 1 to 10 numbers.
Yes.
Okay, Taimish. You come, Shivangi?
Yes, sir.
Shivangi. I'm changing my just enhancing this one. Example two. See, print 1 to 5 numbers. Here one condition, except fourth number. You understand my requirement? Print 1 to 10, 1 to 5 numbers, but except fourth number means I want 1, 2, 3, and 5. 1, 2, 3, 5.
Yes, sir. So I equals to 1.
See, for I, start value, int I equals to 1.
I less than equals to 5.
I less than or equals to 5.
I plus plus.
Good. I plus plus. Open curly braces. Next.
If I not equals to 4.
If not equals to, exclamation, or otherwise, I experimentation equals to 4.
4?
4 open.
Print I.
In this condition, see. I. See this 10th line, if condition close, 11th line, for loop close. It will print 1, 2, 3, 5. 1, 2, 3, 5. Here we inserted condition in that loop. Next, Sri Lalita. Example 3, Sri Lalita. Simple one. Print 1 to 10 numbers. Print 1 to 10 numbers in reverse order. Simple.
Okay, sir.
For
int I equals to 10.
For
int I equals to 10.
Int I equals to
10.
Good. Start value 10. Next.
I is greater than 0.
I is greater than
0
or equals to.
Okay, sir.
Greater than or equals to. Greater than 0 means 1 only. No? I think greater than is enough.
Yeah, greater than is enough, sir.
Enough. Yeah. Greater than 0 means up to 1. Next.
I minus minus.
I
minus.
Minus minus. Unary operator.
Yes, sir.
Next.
System dot out dot
print ln.
I.
Run. Observe 10 to 1. Okay, good. Next, you come, Umadevi. Second loop structure, while loop.
That second example.
Ah.
Quick question. Instead of I greater than 0, what if you say I greater than or equal to 1?
Greater than or equals to?
To 1.
Greater than or equals to 1. Same, na?
Correct.
Same.
Correct.
Say 10 to 1. Same only. Okay. And one more thing. What is computer programming motto? More than one way to achieve any task. But select simplest way. Readable way. Now observe. I greater than or equal to 1 is readable, or just I greater than 0 is readable. Do you understand, Baba Wale? Both are correct. I greater than 0 is equivalent to I greater than or equal to 1. More than one way to achieve any task in computer programming. Select simplest way, readable way. Okay, na?
Thank you.
Welcome. Continue, Umadevi. Second loop, Umadevi. While loop. Already I told, first three loops purpose almost all same. Based on your convenience, you can use them. Suppose for loop. If you know the record count, you can use for loop. Irrespective of the record count, you can use while loop. In our data driven testing, we use while loop. Suppose you are fetching data from a text file or Excel file. You don't know the record count. The record count is dynamic. Today you are using 10 records, tomorrow 20 records. irrespective of the record count, you can use while loop. It will repeat up to end of the file. If you want to use for loop, you must know the record count. Can you tell me, Shivangi? My question is, when to choose for loop and when to choose while loop?
Not sure, sir.
See, Lalita, just now I told na, when to choose for loop and when to choose while loop in.
While loop is
first for loop. What first checks condition? That is do while loop. Don't mix.
Okay, sir.
That is do while loop. We didn't discuss do while loop. See, for loop versus while loop. Both are same in purpose. Repetitive execution. Okay. When we go for loop, if you know the record count, then you can go for loop. For example, here end value is record count.
Yes.
I less than or equals to 10 means 10 is our highest record, record count. If you know the record count, you can use for loop. If you don't know the record count, irrespective of the record count, you can use while loop. Suppose I am fetching data from a file, a text file or Excel file. I don't know the record count. I want to read that file, complete file. Using while loop, you can read the data at the end of file. Today, 100 records are there in that file. Tomorrow, 250 records. It will read up to end of the file. Getting? Any problems, Lalita? Okay. Now tell me, when to choose for loop, when to choose while loop?
For loop is only when we know count, sir.
Record count.
Record count, yes.
If you know the record count, then we can choose. Then you can choose for loop. Irrespective of the record count, you can choose
while loop.
While loop. Suppose you want to, you don't know about number of records in your file. Irrespective of the record count, you want to read up to end of the file. Can read using while loop structure. In our observe Umadevi, in our Selenium testing, data driven testing, most of the time we use while loop. You can use for loop if you know the record count. Suppose you only created the text data file with 10 usernames and 10 passwords, means 10 records, then you can use. Otherwise, use while loop. Irrespective of the record count, it will execute up to end of the file. Continue, Umadevi. Syntax. First, description. Description. It repeats a block of statements. It repeats a block of statements while condition is true. While condition is true. Suppose if you are in true position, then it will repeat. Once you meet false position, it will come out from the loop. See, syntax. Syntax, initialization. Here you need to initialize the variable before loop. Next, while condition, open curly braces, just a minute. Next, statements Next, increment. Increment or decrement. Next, close curly braces. Now, Uma Devi, repeat these three examples. See, irrespective of the record count, you can use while loop. If you know the record count, then no issue, you can use. If you know the record count, you can use while loop. If you don't know the record count, then also you can use. 1 to 10 numbers using while loop. Using while loop. Uma Devi.
Initialize.
Int I equals to 1 semicolon. Next,
while
I less than
equal to 10.
Next, open curly braces. Next, system dot out dot println. I next increment
I plus plus
I equals to I plus 1, that is VB script syntax. Run 1 to 10. Okay na?
Yes.
Okay, Uma Devi. Just a minute. Sivangi, earlier you fulfilled the second one for using for loop. This time using while loop, Sivangi. Print 1 to 5 numbers except fourth number using while loop. Sivangi.
Int I
equals to
1.
Int I equals to 1. Good.
While I less than equals to 10.
While I less than or equals to 5. Okay.
If I not equals to 4.
If I not equals to 4.
Print I
system dot out dot println. Print I
plus plus.
Where?
Look at, sir, after closing the loop.
After closing the condition. After closing the condition, na? Not loop. Loop closing 14th statement. Condition closing 12th statement. Any problem?
Yes. No, sir.
Run the program. 1, 2, 3, 5. Okay, Sivangi. Sri Lalita, third example. Print 1 to 10 numbers in reverse order using while loop this time. While loop.
Okay, sir. Int I equals to 10.
Int I equals to 10.
While I is greater than 0.
Good. I greater than 0. Or greater than or equal to 1. Both are same.
Okay.
Next.
System dot out dot println.
System I. Dot out dot println of I.
I minus minus.
No, close.
I think within.
Immediate. I minus minus. Good.
I minus minus.
Immediate. It will print 10 to 1. Okay. You only continuously, earlier you told irrespective of the condition, at least it executes once. That is dual structure.
Okay, sir.
Observe third structure. Do while is Java keywords. Do is Java keyword, while is Java keyword, loop is English term. Description. Based on your convenience, you can use them. It repeats a block of statements. It's the same. It repeats a block of statements while condition is true. While condition is true. And it executes statements. Execute statements at least once, irrespective of the condition. Syntax. Initialization. Do statements. Next, increment or decrement. Next, close curly braces. While condition, semicolon. Now fulfill these examples. First one, print 1 to 10 numbers, say Sri Lalita.
Okay, sir.
Now tell me, Sri Lalita, what is the difference between while loop and do while loop?
Do while loop execute irrespective of condition
while loop executes a block of statements while condition is true.
Okay, sir.
First it checks the condition. Observe. First it checks the condition. If condition is true, it will execute statements. If condition is false, it will come out from the loop. But do loop, irrespective of the condition, at least it executes statement once. After executing the statements, at the end of the loop, it will check the condition. If condition is true, it will repeat. Otherwise, it will come out from the loop. Final, while condition, it repeats a block of statements while condition is true. If condition is false, it won't execute. If it is do while also same. It repeats a block of statements while condition is true. But irrespective of the loop, it will execute statements at least once. Okay. Now, example one. Continue, Sri Lalita. Print 1 to 10 numbers using do while.
Yes, sir. Int I equals to 1.
Int I equals to 1.
Do.
Do
open curly braces and print I
system dot out dot println
I Immediately, I plus plus.
Good, immediately. I plus plus.
Then after, then close, close braces.
Close
then braces. While.
While.
I is, while condition, I is less than or equals to 10.
Less than or equals to 10.
Okay.
Semicolon. Run. 1 to 10. Shivangi. Not Shivangi this time. Baba Wale. You fulfill this example using do while. Print 1 to 5 numbers except suppose third number. Baba Wale.
I'm ready. I-N-T.
Int.
Int. I
equals to 1 initial value. Next.
Do.
Do. Suppose system.out.println I. Before the statement, immediate immediate after opening the do loop, after opening the do loop, if
correct, if I not
equals to 3,
okay, 3,
next. Next,
line 12. Line 12.
I plus minus, plus.
Minus. No. Minus.
Not minus. Not reverse order. What is our requirement? Print 1 to 5 numbers.
Sorry. Plus.
Okay, cool. Next.
Line 14.
Line 13. Again, close. This is loop close. 11th one. Condition close. After condition close, use increment. Next. 13th one, loop close. While I greater than or equals to 5, semicolon. Then it will print 1, 2, 4, 5. Only one misplacement. Observe do. I not equals to 3, okay. Do I not equals to system close I plus plus while I less than condition. Now observe condition mistake na. Baba wale.
I plus plus.
Run.
I plus plus should be in.
Now okay na? 1, 2, 4, 5 except 3. Any problem time is I plus plus correct position only. Earlier I used incorrect condition. I greater than or equal to 5. No, I less than or equal to 5. Any problem, Taimish?
No, sir.
Okay. Continue, Taimish. This third one. Where is the third example? Print 1 to 10 numbers in reverse order using do-while structure. Do-while structure.
Yes, sir. Int I equals to
int I 10. Equals to 10.
10.
Next, do system
I
system dot out dot println I. Next, I plus plus, sorry, I minus minus. Next,
while condition
I
greater than or equals to 1.
I greater than or equals to 1. Semicolon. Otherwise, you can write I greater than 0, na?
Yes, sir.
Run. Observe 10 to 1. Observe Sri Lalita. I 20. I less than or equals to 10. Observe condition. Is it true?
Sri Lalita. No, sir. It's false. Condition is false.
But it will execute statements at least once, na?
Yes, sir.
Then it will print it will print 20. Then it will come out from there.
Yes, sir.
20. See, last loop, Baba Wale. Actually, this large loop, we don't use this loop in our Selenium test cases. Only first three loops. In first three loops also, you can select either while or for. Do while also rare use. This fourth one, rare use or no use. Enhanced for loop. What is the functionality of enhanced for loop? It executes all elements in an array. It executes all elements in an array. So it is quite opposite to else if structure. Else if, it will pick one condition block out of number of else if blocks. Here it will execute all elements, means all blocks. Like, observe the syntax array initialization. Next, for declaration. Next, expression or array. expression or array. Open curly braces. Next, statements, close curly braces. Observe Baba Wale. I will provide an example. We didn't discuss arrays. We will discuss arrays, I think, tomorrow or day after tomorrow. So don't focus on array declaration. For declaring arrays in Java, we have three methods. I'm using third method for this one. For next example, second method. You don't focus on array syntax. String. Languages. Square brackets. It is array symbol. String is data type, languages is array name. Initialize, suppose COBOL language, C, next, Java, next, Python, open and close curly braces, semicolon. Next, I want to print this array using enhanced for loop. For declaration, we declared string type array. Declare string type variable to hold that string type data one by one. COBOL first, next C, next Java, Python. So we declared string type array, declare string type variable to hold the data. String, suppose lang, colon, here array name is languages. Array name is languages, close parenthesis, open curly braces. Next. System dot out dot println. This example in Eclipse IDE. Lang. It will print COBOL, C, Java, Python. One by one. Oh, 12th line. Oh. Curly braces. For loop close. Enhanced for close. Next, 12th line, main method close. 13th line, class close. Run. Observe Baba Wale, COBOL, C, Java, Python. It is executing all elements in that array. Example. Next, example two. Observe this time, Uma Devi, you come. This time I am taking integer type array. Okay.
Yes.
Suppose int a equals to 10, b equals to 5 for integer type variables. Purpose is there, I will explain. Int math operations. Math operations equals to new int square brackets 3. Size of the array is 3. This is second method. We will discuss this one in arrays chapter. New int math operations array symbol Okay. Next, observe math operations. First, array index starts from 0. 0 equals to, suppose, A plus B. Next, A minus B. Next, A into B. Size 3. 0, first index, 1, second index, 2, third index. Next, take integer type variable. For int operation colon math operations, open curly braces, system dot out dot println operation. It will print A and B addition, next subtraction, next multiplication values. Means 15, 5, 50. 15, 5, 50. See, these are about loop structures. Tomorrow we will discuss Java branching statements. Java branching statements, we have three branching statements: break, continue, and return. Return is useful in our Selenium test automation. Return. In user defined methods, we use return statement. Method with return a value type methods are there. In the type of methods, we use return statement. Break, continue, we will use in conditions and loops. Limited use, anyhow, that we will discuss tomorrow. Now I am going to close the today's class. Any queries? Confirm one by one. Baba Wale, any queries regarding this today's class?
I'm good, thank you very much.
Welcome. Shivangi?
No, sir, no queries.
Welcome. Sri Lalita?
I'm good, sir.
Welcome. Thaimesh?
I'm good, sir.
Welcome. Uma Devi, any queries raise?
No, sir. Fine, sir. Thank you.
Welcome. We'll meet tomorrow, same time. Thank you.